combina questa specializzazione con un punto di specializzazione sulla trattatistica musicale, su cui non parlerà oggi, ma conviene menzionare che dirige la collana Le regole della musica e altre edizioni e commenti di trattati teorici. Ma oggi ci parlerà su uffici di Trento che entrano in un sistema politico storico molto molto interessante. La parola è sua.
Thank you for your presentation, thank you to the organizer, because I am here, and I will speak of this history of exclusion. Migration of offices, like the migration today of from the countries of the overseas. The creation of the Prince Bishopric of Trent just after the year 1000 confirmed the special attention of the German emperors which the city had enjoyed and was to continue to enjoy in the following centuries. This act reinforced the conditions for close dependence of Trentino on Germanic war, which Otto I had outlined by annexing it together with Verona, first to the Duchy of Bavaria 1952, and then to the Duchy of Carinthia 1976, with a view to safeguarding control of the Alpine passes so as to ensure easy access to the Po Valley. Among the implications of these policies for local culture, cultic and liturgical aspects play an important role. The Sacramentarium Udalricianum, which owes its name to the first bishop of Trent, whose investiture was decided by the temporal power, Udalrico II, 1022-55, is an excellent example of these influences. On the one hand, through him the new saints, Ulrich, Bishop of Augsburg, Willibald, Bishop of Eichstätt, Saint Benedict, Abbot, Bishop Martin, Saint Goldemont, Saint Columban, Abbot, the martyr Afra, Valburg, Bridget, Gertrude, Odile, all join the Tridentine sanctoral cycle, or are still remembered in the liturgy alongside the local patron saints. On the other hand, it contains a diptych with the names of the deceased to be remembered in the canon of the Mass, that adds an interesting list of rulers, nobles and laymen to the bishops and clergy from Trent and neighboring dioceses. All of them were presumably benefactors bound to it by spiritual relationship. Its genesis is probably related to the burial of a young member of the imperial family, the Duke of Swabia Hermann IV, which took place in the cathedral in early August 1038. This shows the special relationship between the Church in Trent and the imperial family, and its moral influence in the diocese. Among the consequences of such a special relationship, which is indicative of a unique bond of trust, is the fact that until the time of Federico Vanga, these bishops of Trent held the office of Missus Dominicus, Chancellor or Imperial Vicar for Italy, almost continuously for two centuries. The relations with Germany were confirmed when under Bishop Adelprito II, 1156-72, the liturgical library of the cathedral was enriched with the addition of a new sacramentary, which was given the name Adelpretiano after the bishop himself. The data which emerges from the analysis of his santorale exactly matches our historical knowledge of the political and religious relations between Regensburg and the Principality of Trent. In 1156, Bishop Adelpreto was present in the Diet of Regensburg, where the question of Bavaria was settled and the Duchy of Austria was created. This Santorale contains an original form of the Mass and, alongside the patron saint of Trent, it includes the martyr Saint Emmerams, Bishop of Regensburg, among the litanies of For Holy Saturday. The oldest musical witness to the office of Saint Vigilio, the patron saint of Trent and its cathedral, dates back to the period of Bishop Altemanno, 1124-39. It's a parchment sheet from the middle of the 12th century, found in the city archives of Bersanone, which was detached from the cover of a Registrum Sancti Michaelis of 1444. Altemanno was the first bishop of Trent, chosen using the system of canonical election established by the Treaty of Worms in 1122, at the end of the investiture controversy, with the form prescribed for the Kingdom of Germany. It seems natural, therefore, to notice the influence of his acceptance of specific elements of Gregorian reform in some aspects of his pastoral ministry. For example, his renewed interest in the cult of the local saint, a vital ideological factor for the promotion of civic identity and the unity of all the forces active in the city. The cult of local saint derived without doubt from the need to consolidate the independence and freedom of the local church. It is not surprising that an aspect of this was the recovery of old or the introduction of new offices. While the 13th century saw the construction of the magnificent cathedral in its present form, it also marked the beginning of a progressive deterioration of governance by the bishop. The Emperor Friedrich II's policy had fatal consequences for peace in Trentino. In 1236, he entrusted the principality to a secular mayor, thereby humiliating the bishop Aldrighetto di Campo, and in 1239, he united it with the March of Treviso, virtually handing it over to Ezzelino da Romano. This already complex situation was further complicated by the expansionist ambition of Count Albert III of Tyrol. As he was appointed advocate of the church in Trent, he took advantage of the benefit deriving from his position to extend gradually from the north the domination of what, in theory, it was his job to defend as advocate. This started a century-long feud between the families of the Counts of Tyrol and the Bishop of Trent, a story of extortion, oppression and violence. Not until the first half of the 15th century is it possible to have a complete documentation of the musical repertoire used during the daily celebration of the Mass and office for the entire liturgical year in the Cathedral of Trent. The series of the 9 graduals and the illuminated antiphoners produced at this time is now kept in the chapter library and in the Diocesan Museum of the city. The repertoire found in this series belongs to the tradition classified as Secundum Consuetudinem Curiae Romanae, which developed in the wake of the liturgical reform of Pope Innocent III. It was accepted by the Franciscans, who were instrumental in spreading it across much of Europe, at the expense of various local traditions. Their liturgical books, also called Romano-Franciscan, in which the repertoire known as Gregorian chant was now well established, became the model for choir books of all ecclesiastical institutions. This also happened in Trent. As well as including the Roman repertory, the liturgical choir books of the cathedral also reveal an artistic influence, reveal artistic influences from Veneto area. In other words, in this period, the Trent liturgical book records a radical change of direction of the origin of their cultural influences. Several different factors explain the reason for this change. The main reason was the change in the function of the Adige Valley. From being the imperial route to Italy, it had gradually assumed a unique role as the main channel of trade between the Veneto and Po Valley city and Germany, even though the Tyrolean counts to the north did their utmost to hinder the economy of Trent. Moreover, in the second half of the 14th century, the bishopric was governed by bishops who were subservient of the Habsburg goals. The bishops were, in fact, elected and imposed by the Habsburg, for example, Alberto di Ortenburg, 1363-90, or they were in direct conflict with the powerful family, and therefore forced to spend long periods in exile. For this reason, it became standard practice to arrange for suffragan bishops, often chosen from the among the members of the Franciscan order, to look after the spiritual needs of the diocese. In actual fact, four friar minors were delegated to that office between 1350 and 1450. In this context is to be placed the story of three offices, complete with prayers, lessons, antiphons, responsories, chants of the Mass, and German notation. They are contained in a manuscript in Trent Municipal Library. Two offices for Saint Stanislaus, Bishop of Krakow, and Saint Hedwig of Silesia are rhythmical. The third, in honor of Saint Adalbert of Bohemia, is in prose. A long note at the end of the manuscript, added by Bishop Johannes Sinderbach, 1465-86, inform us that the preparation of these offices was the result of the efforts of two bishops of Trent, Alexander of Masovia, 1423-44, and Georg Hack, 1446-65, who tried to impose the cult of the patron saints of their homelands to the diocese. The saints were, respectively, the Polish Saint Adalbert and Stanislaus, and the Silesian Saint Hedwig. The codex consists of 50 pages measuring 33x24 cm and is written using typical Textualis Gothica formata writing with German musical notation commonly referred to as Hufnagelschrift or Horseshoe-Nagelschrift. These characteristics are those of a libellus used to contain tracts or short treatises, which was widely used for many centuries in the field of liturgy for the transmission of feasts of special rituals or special rituals used for many centuries. used for many centuries in the field of liturgy for the transmission of feasts or special rituals, including the local offices of some saints. The latter is the case of the manuscript in question. The first part, folios 1 to 20, with the offices of Saint Stanislaus and Adalbert, was written before 1444 by order of Alexander of Masovia. In 1474, Johannes Hinderbach commissioned Martin Rautenstock of Kempen to add the offices of Saint Edwin to the first two quinternions, transcribing it from a paper copy brought from Silesia by his predecessor Georg Gapp, and ordered Hinderbach that those offices be celebrated every year, saltem a clero in divinis laudibus or et oris canonicis. This story, however, did not gain acceptance, and Hinderbach was forced to acknowledge that negligentia eorum qui coro ecclesiae presunt intermisse sunt et minime decantate. There can be no doubt that the opinion of the humanist bishop was excessively benevolent, taking into account that what we know of the relation between Alexander of Masovia and the citizens of Trent, it would seem more realistic use the term boycott instead of negligence. On the one hand, the prelate did not conceal his aversion to the city and its inhabitants. On the other, the different social groups in Trent were just as hostile to the bishop for a number of reasons. The main motive for the resentment of the subject against the prince bishop was the fact that he was a foreigner, surrounded by fellow countrymen who were entrusted with important positions in the church and in the administration of the state, to the detriment of people in Trent. Secondly, he favored the Jews by raising the monthly rate of interest they could charge in loans. Finally, he aroused the opposition of the Tyroleans, and even the section of the population whose fortune depended on mercantile activity. In order to oppose the rebellious bishop, the Habsburg probably organized a sort of boycott, which north of the principality and indirectly jeopardized the activity of the city authorities. This reason may well be enough to justify the discontent against the Polish prelate and the saints who were dear to him. In this history of exclusion, there is a significant contrast in the treatment given to the rhythmic offices of Saint Catherine of Alexandria and Saint Margaret of Antioch. Added in 1518 by a certain Paolo of the Order of the Minori Osservanti in folios 114 to 127 of the Antiphonari F of the Cathedral. A further addition to the choir books, which reflect the consequences of a crime, is even more significant. The murder of a child, Simone Unverdorben, which took place in Trent on March the 23rd, 1475, gave rise to a cult that spread amazingly quickly in the wake of the trial of Jews accused of ritual infanticide. It also became popular in southern Germany. Bishop Johannes Hinderbach immediately had a special chapel erected for him next to St. Peter's Church in Trent. If for the moment is necessary to gloss over the economic and social factor that may have helped to strengthen the anti-Semitic prejudice and the hatred against the Jews during the intricate and contested trial, it is appropriate to point out that the growth in veneration for the Blessed Simonino resulted in the granting of a celebration of the office by the Pope Sixtus V on June 8, 1588. The addition The edition, which was immediately printed, gave him the opportunity also to include the new offices for Saint Vigilio and Santa Mascenza, which should be seen as part of the activity of harmonization of the service with the requirements of the Council of Trent. At a local level, this was carried out with particular zeal by Cardinal Ludovico Madruzzo, 1567-1600. The office recently granted and these new offices, together with their masses, which were reworked ex novo at that time, had in the meantime been copied into the cathedral choir books, replacing the previous one, of which no trace remained. The friar in charge of copying the new office, whose text differ from the traditional biographical form in favor of a more ascetic vision of the patron saint of Trent life, indicate in an illuminated letter that he had carried out the task in 1584. The office of the Blessed Simonino, added to the other part of the same antiphonary, is instead the work of a very accurate end of an unknown copyist, probably from the same period. Thank you.